So there is a one question, and the question is that why suction line diameter is higher than the discharge line diameter of the centrifugal pump. Here you can see that this is my centrifugal pump, this is the suction line, and this one is my discharge line. Now the question arises that why this suction side has a larger dia and this discharge side has a lower dia. Okay, and as per the, if you simply see that the relation between the area and pressure, then you will find that if area increases, then pressure is also increases. Got it my point? Okay, this we know. Okay, we have also discussed about it in our previous videos, and as per the continuity equation, you will see that Q is equal to A into V. So if V increase the area, so velocity decreases. Means if you will increase the area, so velocity decreases, and we know that as the velocity decreases, so pressure increases. It means that yes, this statement is good enough, right? So our question is that why there is a 8 inch suction line diameter, okay, and here is the discharge line diameter is 6 inches. So what is the main reason? What could be the reason? So the reason is very simple. The first thing is that in suction side, okay, there is a, in, if I talk about the centrifugal pump, so there is a impellers casing is there, right? So what happens that sometimes the cavitation occurs, okay? I hope you heard about it, cavitation, and there is a two word, I hope you know about it, and we have also uploaded the video about it, cavitation and NPSH. Okay, these are the two words, I hope you heard about it. So what happens sometimes, the cavitation occurs because of the your pressure of the fluid or liquid goes down or goes below the vapor pressure of that liquid, okay, at that temperature, because the pressure is related to the temperature. Got it my point? So what happens that the pressure at the suction side, what happens that the pressure of the liquid goes below the vapor pressure of that liquid at that temperature. So at that time what happens, the cavitation occurs. Why the cavitation occurs? The bubble formation, vapors generates there, boiling occurs. This is the very important question, right? And I have seen that so many videos are there in YouTube, but the statements are completely wrong. That's why I am uploading this video. Okay, so boiling occurs, so because of that the vapors, bubbles occurs, right? Bubbles occur. So when these bubbles occurs, so they damage your internal parts of the centrifugal pump. It may be impeller or it may be casing, right? So they damage these things. So for that, what we do, we increases, or we while sizing, what we do, we give some margin at the suction side of the centrifugal pump. We increases the dia of the suction side, okay, we increases the dia of the suction side. Why we increases the dia? Because you also know that if we increase the dia, so area will increase, and because of that the pressure increases, okay. And if we know the NPSH, if we know about the NPSH, so what is the NPSH? Means net positive suction head. Means net positive, it should be positive suction head. Let's suppose your suction side pressure minus vapor pressure, okay, this is the difference, this difference is a NPSH. So your suction side pressure or this net should be always positive. If it is positive, it means that yes, your fluid is okay, your pump will be run smooth, okay. But if it will be negative, then cavitation could be occur here. Got it my point? Please understand the reason behind it, okay. So if it should be positive, if it will be positive, your pump will be running okay. Got it my points? Otherwise your pump will be not running okay, there may be a cavitation. So what we do, we increase this side, suction side, we increase the dia, okay, as compared to the discharge one. Got it, my point? So now what happens that as the area increases, your pressure will be increased and your NPSS will be positive enough. Okay, and there is also, if you have heard, there is two NPSS, NPSHA and NPSHR. Could you please let me in the comments box what is the difference between NPSH available and NPSH required? If you know, let me in the comments box. There are one more reason which I personally feel. The reason is that here we have decreases the dia. Okay, we have decreases the dia. So there could be two things. The friction loss will be increased. Okay, but there is one thing also happened. We have to transfer that fluid at particular location. Okay, for that we will require a velocity, right? So if we decrease the dia, so velocity will be increased. Okay, that could be the one reason there is the dia is less. This could be the reason, but this reason is valid enough, right? If you know another reason, let me in the comments box. That's all for the today's video. Thanks for watching. Till then, keep learning.